state versus stock market.
Ooh.
Folks, let's welcome Toastmaster Matt Sapp.
Real estate versus the stock market. Which is a better investment? It really depends on what you need in life. For some people, it'll be real estate. For some people, it'll be the stock market. I'm gonna go over what's really transpired in the last, let's say, 15 years with the real estate and stock market. So you get a feel of what's happened and why it's happened. Real estate, back in the early 2000s, it didn't really move until after 9/11. Let me explain that, and that also affects the stock market. 10 years prior to the very low interest rates of 2002, 2003, real estate didn't move. It actually went down in value and was flat. We'll say from 1990 to about 2002, property down here, because it's a very regional thing, stayed the same. After 2002, we were attacked 9/11, we just came out of the tech bubble, and the economy was in a recession, it was kind of a disaster. So they lowered rates very low. And what happens when rates become very low, money becomes very cheap for investors. So this is when people could be able to get mortgages at a really cheap cost, which the more mortgages that people will take out, there's more demand. When there's more demand, it increases the price of homes. So homes increased. It actually formed a bubble. And around 2006, they started to increase rates again. And homes, they almost doubled, I'd say, in value, even tripled in some places. Homes actually started to crash. The prices of real estate actually went down. And there's a lot of other things that were going on. Banks were just giving loans to anybody. They weren't checking credit, they weren't doing background checks. You came in there, you said you want a loan, they say, okay, here you go. Interest only, don't put anything down, it's your home. So eventually found out none of these people could afford the homes they were buying. So they cracked down on these homes, and the market just disintegrated. That's the way I'm gonna put it. All these buyers were also effervescent about buying homes. Now we're all freaked out because they were underwater, they owed more than the house was worth, they couldn't get out, and everyone was in a mess that bought homes they couldn't afford. On the flip side, this made an incredible market for people that could afford homes after the market and the prices bottomed. At this point in time, people that could buy a house with cash, the people that can't afford them, the bank just wanted to get rid of them. So $450,000 homes were purchased for $150,000, and people then were just renting out homes. And home market didn't actually bottom until Obama ran for his second term. And what he did was he just froze the foreclosures during around the 2012 before he got reelected. And he had an $8,000 tax credit for first-time homebuyers. This started the market, and coincidentally, hedge funds bought up all the property, distressed property, and real estate's been going up since then. And right now, we're still at all-time lows, basically 0%, 3.5% fixed, cheap mortgages. The stock market. The stock market, we had a bubble, a tech bubble in the year 2000. Everyone wanted to be in the stock market. The guy cutting your lawn, he would talk to me because my family is in the financial industry. And anyone and everyone wanted to own .com this, .com that. And before you know it long, the stocks became really overvalued and they crashed. Then we had 9/11, the market crashed even more. The market came back also in tandem with the real estate market, because the real estate, when you buy real estate, it's an enormous purchase and brings a lot of money to the economy. When there's a lot of money in the economy, when people making $60,000 selling a home, they turn around and take that money and they shop and they buy and spurs all their demand. Then that money that's bought, purchased, and sold is then bought in other industries. So it's kind of like increase the money supply, you increase the earnings, you increase everything. So then when the bubble burst in the year 2006, it eventually happened in 2008 is when they really were tightening, even though it topped in 2006. Everything, about a third of the money supply actually dried up because they increased rates and the stock market tumbled, stock market crashed, and then they lowered rates, they started funding, and then everything came back. Now, which should you purchase? Which should you invest in? I would like everyone outside the speech to look at if you invest 30 years in real estate versus 30 years in the stock market at any year in history, what's a better return? Do that on your own. I'm not gonna tell you. What I will tell you is the real return over 150 years of real estate, inflation adjusted, returns you 1%. The real return inflation adjusted in the stock market returns you 7%. There are times you don't want to invest in the stock market because it's overpriced. There are times you don't want to invest in the real estate market because it's overpriced. There are times where you can make money in neither. There are times you make money in both. It's being smart about picking which has the right value at the right time. See, I even question, should you go to the stock market now when we're at close to all-time highs? Should you go to real estate market now when we're at all-time highs? Again, it really depends on where you are in life and what you're gonna do. If you have no money to invest, but you have enough money to put a down payment on a home, you could put a down payment on a home, and if you can rent it out, and that covers all of your costs, which people do now, they'll pay your mortgage. So you could actually buy a home now with barely any money, $20,000, $30,000. Someone can pay your mortgage for you, and 30 years from now, the home will be paid off because someone else is paying it for you. So that's one alternative. Which is a better way to protect against inflation? And the real answer is stock market. I know people say it's a hard asset, and hard assets are the best because it's tangible, you hold it, you feel it, it's real. But the price of real estate is a play on the money supply. And since it's a play on the money supply, it doesn't matter if the cost of goods go up. So when you're paying more at the pump for gas, is your home going up? No. The revenue on Chevron and Exxon is going up. When you pay more for groceries, is your home going up? No. The companies that are selling those goods are going up. When you pay more for healthcare, is your home going up? No. Pfizer and the other companies that sell pharmaceuticals go up. So to absorb inflation directly, it's to invest in the companies that are selling you the products. So whatever investment is right for you, I can't tell you, but I will tell you this. You should invest if you can. Fellow Toastmasters.
Thank you, Matt Saverin.